Hello students, welcome to NIUS. I am Dr. Padmaja Saxena from Dayal Singh College, University of Delhi. So today we will be dealing with the chapter Renewable Sources of Energy, which is 30B. In the previous program, we have discussed about some of the important non-conventional or renewable sources of energy, such as solar energy, wind energy, hydropower, tidal and hydrogen, etc. Now there is use of alternative resources such as biomass, geothermal and hydrogen as a source of vast energy resources. The energy resources can be used with minimal environmental degradation. It's for these reasons there is growing interest in renewable energy resources. This lesson deals with the renewable energy resources. So the objective of the topics are: define biomass and explain its uses including biogas. Then describe the concept of biofuels like ethanol, biodiesel, petrocrops and list their uses. Then geothermal energy, explanation of hydrogen energy and its uses, fuel cell technology, and then in the end the description of the limitations of alternative sources of energy and the state the thrust areas of renewable energy programs in India. So uses of conventional energy sources of India, as you can see in the diagram, we have discussed earlier also the solar photovoltaic use, then waste energy, wind energy, biomass and hydropowers. So first of all, we will start with the biomass. Biomass is a renewable energy resource derived from plants and animal waste. The energy from biomass is released on burning or breaking the chemical bonds of organic molecules formed during photosynthesis. As you can see in the diagram on the right hand side, the different types of biomass. Biomass represents an indirect form of solar energy. Biomass fuels can be used directly or they can be transformed into more convenient form and then used. Energy from biomass is the oldest fuel used by humans. More than 1 million people in the world still use wood as primary source of energy for cooking. So now we will discuss the sources of biomass. So there are solid source, liquid and gaseous sources of biomass. Solid biomass fuels are like the wood, logs and pellets, charcoal, agricultural waste, stalks and other plant debris, timbering waste like branches, tree tops and wood chips, animal wastes which includes the dung, aquatic plants like the kelp and water hyacinth, urban waste which includes the paper, cardboard and other combustible materials. Then liquid biofuels which includes ethanol, methanol, gasol, biodiesel, and gaseous biofuels which include the synthetic natural gas which is also called as the biogas, wood gas and carbon dioxide. Biomass can be burned directly as a source for cooking, heating, lighting, generating steam, for industrial use, for producing electricity. Can be used to generate gaseous fuels or it can be converted into alcohol by distillation. Methane and biogas can be produced from urban wastes in landfills and sewage at wastewater treatment plants. In some facilities, manure from livestock and other organic waste is converted by microorganisms in digestion chambers to form methane, which is burned to produce electricity, used in fuel cell or used as fuel for vehicles. Molasses obtained from sugarcane is fermented to produce ethanol that can be used in automobiles. Half a kilo of dry plant tissue can produce as much as 1,890 kilocalories of heat, which is equivalent to the heat available from a quarter of kilogram of coal. Uses of biomass. Traditional use of biomass is more than its use in modern application. In the developed world, biomass is important for applications such as combined heat and power generations. In countries like Finland, USA, and Sweden, use of biomass energy is increasing. Biomass fuel used in India accounts for about 1/3 of the total fuel used in the country, and it amounts to 90% of the rural households. Instead of burning loose biomass directly, it can be converted into briquettes or bricks to improve its utility and convenience of use. Bricks can be used as fuel in place of coal in traditional chulas and furnaces or in a gasifier. Advantages of biomass energy. Biomass is an important source of energy and the most important fuel worldwide after coal, oil, and natural gas. Burning of biomass does not increase atmospheric carbon dioxide, as biomass was formed by atmospheric carbon dioxide and the same amount of carbon dioxide is released on burning. Biomass is renewable and free from net carbon dioxide emissions and is abundantly available on the earth in the form of firewood, agriculture residues, cattle dung, city garbage, etc. Bioenergy in the form of biogas, which is derived, from biomass is supposed to be one of the key energy resources for global sustainable development. Bagasse as biofuel. Bagasse is the leftover of sugar cane after it is crushed and its juice extracted. It is used to generate electricity. About 3500 megawatt of power can be generated from bagasse in the existing 453 sugar mills in the country. Around 270 megawatt of power has already been commissioned and more is under construction. For every 100 tons of sugarcane crushed, 30 tons of wet bagasse is produced. Biogas plant. The biogas plant consists of two compartments. One is the digester or fermentation tank and the other is the gas holder. The digester is a cube-shaped or cylindrical waterproof container with an inlet into which the fermentable mixture is introduced in the form of a liquid slurry. So, this is the diagram of the biogas plant. The gas holder is normally an airproof steel container that floats like a ball on the fermentation mix, cuts off air to the digester and collects the gas generated. The gas holder is equipped with a gas outlet, while the digester is provided with an overflow pipe to lead the sludge out into a drainage pit. Any biodegradable substance can be fermented anaerobically, that is in the absence of oxygen, by methane producing bacteria, which are also called as methanogens. Cow dung or feces are collected and put in a biogas digester or fermenter, which is a large vessel in which fermentation can take place. A series of chemical reactions occur in the presence of methanogenic bacteria, leading to the production of methane and carbon dioxide. So, this is how you can find out that 25 kg of fresh dung, what will be the advantage if you use it as a biogas and disadvantage if you use it directly. Methanogenesis is a microbial process involving many complex and differently interacting species, but most notably the methane producing bacteria. The biogas process consists of three stages: hydrolysis, acidification, and methane formation. So, this is the process you can see here. Potential of biogas in India. In India, the estimate for the production of biogas is about, this is equivalent to 6.6 crore domestic LPG cylinders, which is equivalent to 5% of the total LPG consumption in the country today. The next is the use of petrocrops for producing fuel. So, petrocrop means these are the plants which provide liquid hydrocarbons as a substitute of liquid fuels, which are later converted to petroleum hydrocarbons. So, petrocrops, there is a need for alternative energy providing sources that can be regenerated. Recent researches suggest that hydrocarbon producing plants can become alternative energy sources, which can be inexhaustible and ideal for liquid fuel. Petro plants or petro crops can be grown on land which are unfit for agriculture and not covered with forests. Plant species that produce substances or products can be extracted in an economically viable way. Now, the plants belonging to the families like Asclepiaceae, Asteraceae, Anarchidaceae, Euphorbiaceae, Convolvulaceae, Caprifoliaceae, Lamiaceae and Moraceae are usually used. Now, Jatropha carcass is an important petro plant. Biocrude is obtained by tapping the latex, followed by coagulation or by extraction of the dry biomass using a suitable solvent in cases where latex tapping is not possible. Biocrude is a complex mixture of liquids, terpenoids, triglycerides, phytosterols, waxes and other modified isoprenoid compounds. Hydrocracking of biocrude can convert it into several useful products like gasoline, which is an automobile fuel, gas oil and kerosene. So, some of the petrocrop species are Calotropis, Euphorbia, Jatropha carcass, Pittosporum and Parthenium. Next, we come to the geothermal energy. Geothermal energy is natural heat from the interior of the earth that can be used to generate electricity as well as to heat up the buildings. In the right is the geothermal power station. The core of the earth is very hot and it is possible to make use of this geothermal energy. These are areas where there are volcanoes, hot spring and geysers and methane under the water in the oceans and seas. The utilization of geothermal energy for the production of electricity dates back to the early part of the 20th century. For 50 years, the generation of electricity from geothermal energy was confined to Italy, and interest in this technology was slow to spread elsewhere. In the year 1943, geothermal hot water was used for the first time in Iceland. At present, in 21 countries, the internal heat of the earth is used to produce electricity. However, at the global level, geothermal energy supplies less than 0.15% of the total energy supply. Geothermal resources fall into three major categories. One is geopressurized zones, second is the hot rock zones, and the third are the hydrothermal convection zones. Of these three, only the first one, which is geopressurized zone, is currently being exploited on a commercial basis. Geothermal energy in India. In India, northern western Himalayas and the western coast are considered as geothermal areas. The Geological Survey of India has already identified more than 350 hot spring sites. Satellites like IRS-1 helps in locating geothermal areas. The Puga Valley in the Ladakh region has the most promising geothermal field. An experimental 1 kW generator is under operation in this area. It is being used mainly for poultry farming, mushroom cultivation and pashmina wool processing, all of which needs high temperature. Environmental impact of geothermal energy. Geothermal energy can pose several environmental problems, which includes on-site noise, emissions of gas and disturbance at drilling sites, disposal sites, roads and pipelines and power plants during its development. The steam contains hydrogen sulfide gas, which has the odor of rotten eggs and cause air pollution. The minerals in the steam are also toxic to fish and they are corrosive to pipes and equipment requiring constant maintenance. Hydrogen energy. Hydrogen gas is being considered as the fuel for the future. When hydrogen gas burns in the air or in fuel cells, it combines with oxygen gas to produce non-polluting water vapor, and fuel cells directly convert hydrogen into electricity. Widespread use of hydrogen as fuel would greatly reduce the problem of air pollution and danger of global warming, because there will not be any carbon dioxide emission. Obtaining a large amount of pure hydrogen for commercial purposes is a problem because hydrogen is present in combination with other elements such as oxygen, carbon and nitrogen. Hydrogen has to be produced from either water or organic compounds like methane, etc., requiring large amount of energy, and it is also a very costly proposition. Hydrogen is a pollution-free, cost-effective manner, and if technologies such as fuel cells can be made cost-effective, then hydrogen has the potential to provide clean alternative energy for diverse uses including lighting, power, heating, cooling, transportation and many more. Fuel cell technology. Fuel cells are highly efficient power generating systems that produce electricity by combining fuel, which is hydrogen and oxygen, in an electrochemical reaction. Or fuel cells are electrochemical devices. Fuel cell convert the chemical energy of a fuel directly and very effectively into electricity and heat, thus doing away with combustion. So this is the structure and function of a fuel cell. Hydrogen and phosphoric acid are the most common type of fuel cells. Fuel cells that run on methanol, ethanol and natural gas are also available. A fuel cell consists of an electrolyte sandwiched between two electrodes. Oxygen passes over one electrode and hydrogen over the other, and they react electrochemically to generate electricity, water and heat. Traditional methods generating electricity require combustion of fuel, and the resultant heat is used to produce steam to run turbines which generate electricity. It involves loss of heat and thus not very efficient. On the other hand, in chemical fuel cells, chemical energy is converted directly into electricity, thus are more efficient and do not produce harmful gases. Basic components of a hydrogen burning fuel cell are: oxygen and hydrogen are added to the fuel cell in the electrolyte solution. The reactants remain separated from one another and upon ionization migrate through the electrolyte solution from one electrode to another. The flow of electrons from the negative to the positive electrode is diverted along its path into an electrical motor supplying current to keep the motor running. In order to maintain this reaction, hydrogen and oxygen are added when required. When hydrogen is used in a fuel cell, waste products are only oxygen and water. Using natural gas like methane in fuel cells produces some pollutants, but the amount is only about 1% of that would be produced by burning fossil fuels in an internal combusting engine or a conventional power plant. Fuel cells have efficiency levels up to 55% as compared to 35% of conventional power plants. The emission of greenhouse gases is significantly low carbon dioxide, as only water vapor is emitted. Fuel cell systems are excellent options for small-scale decentralized power generation. Fuel cells can supply combined heat and power to buildings, hospitals, airports, and military installations at remote locations. Fuel cell technology and environment. Fuel cells are efficient and clean energy producer. Fuel cells have been used in space flights and being introduced in electric vehicles for reducing urban air pollution. Fuel cells powered vehicles have very high energy conversion efficiency and near zero pollution. Fuel cell powered EVs, electric vehicles, they score over battery operated vehicles in terms of increased efficiency and easier and faster refueling. So, this is all about the other renewable sources other than sun, wind and water. So, we can summarize the chapter that biomass is one of the oldest form of fuel used by humans, used as the primary source of fuel in rural areas. Efforts are being done to produce ethanol from sugarcane. In coming years, petrocrops will become a major resource of fuel for vehicles. Geothermal energy is a natural heat from Earth's interior that is used as energy source. Hydrogen gas can become an important fuel of the future, especially when used in fuel cells. Fuel cells are highly efficient power generating electrochemical systems that produce electricity by combining fuel and oxygen. It converts the chemical energy of a fuel directly and very efficiently into electricity and heat, thus doing away with the combustion. So, this is all about the renewable sources of energy. Thank you.